ancient observatories, messages to the gods, or perhaps landing strips for extraterrestrial visitors, as some pop culture enthusiasts have boldly suggested. From the moment pilots first spotted them from the sky in the 1920s, the Nazca Lines entered the realm of global fascination. Today, thanks to groundbreaking technology and artificial intelligence, scientists may have finally cracked the code behind these cryptic carvings. Origins and discovery. The Nazca Lines lie nestled in the arid deserts of southern Peru, a region where rain is nearly non-existent. This dry environment has helped preserve the geoglyphs for centuries. Although they have been mentioned as early as the 16th century, it wasn't until the age of aviation that their full scope became apparent. In the late 1920s, commercial and military pilots flying over the region were stunned to see giant shapes sprawled across the desert. These included straight lines stretching miles, geometric forms, and intricate animal depictions. The visuals captivated archaeologists and sparked the world's imagination. One of the first scholars to study the lines systematically was Peruvian archaeologist Toribio Mejia Quespe in 1927. Yet it was American historian Paul Kosok who famously observed them aligning with the winter solstice sunset in 1941. Kosok described the Nazca Desert as, quote, the largest astronomy book in the world. This sparked the popular theory that these lines were ancient astronomical markers. German mathematician Maria Reiche carried Kosok's work further, dedicating four decades to the preservation and study of the geoglyphs. Her passionate belief in their astronomical significance became central to public understanding of the lines for years. The Nazca themselves, a civilization that thrived from roughly 1 to 700 AD, are believed to be the architects of these marvels. They created the lines by removing dark, oxidized stones from the desert surface, exposing the lighter colored earth beneath. This simple yet effective method has preserved the art for millennia. The lack of wind and rain in the region meant these shallow trenches could survive largely undisturbed. Despite early fascination, the Nazca Lines remained shrouded in mystery. Theories ranged widely from agricultural centers to alien landing strips. Shifting theories.
I'm here in southern Peru in the remote Nazca Desert, and this is a Nazca Line that depicts a giant whale. From here, it might not look like much, because to really see the Nazca Lines, you need a completely different perspective.
For much of the 20th century, astronomical explanations dominated discussions about the Nazca Lines. Maria Reiche championed the idea that many geoglyphs served calendrical or celestial functions. She believed that certain lines aligned with solstice points and that the animal figures mirrored constellations. This theory gained traction and defined public perception for decades. However, as newer generations of archaeologists began to test these ideas, doubts started to surface. In the 1970s, American researchers began re-examining the lines using a multidisciplinary approach. They questioned the astronomical theory's validity, noting that many lines did not align with significant celestial events. Instead, archaeologists like Johann Reinhard suggested that a more grounded explanation was at play. He proposed that the lines played a role in water-related rituals. In a desert where rainfall was rare and survival depended on water, this made practical sense. According to Reinhard, the lines were likely pathways used during ceremonies aimed at securing water and ensuring agricultural fertility. Anthony Avani, a respected archaeoastronomer, supported Reinhard's perspective. He highlighted the design of trapezoids and broad shapes that could accommodate groups of people. Rather than pointing to celestial bodies, these spaces may have functioned as stages for communal gatherings and ritualistic processions. Avani emphasized that ritual, not astronomy, was likely the line's true purpose. Adding to the ritualistic interpretation was the prevalence of animal symbolism. In Andean cultures, animals were often linked to environmental elements. The hummingbird, for example, symbolized fertility. Spiders were associated with rain, and monkeys came from regions rich in water. So these geoglyphs could represent offerings or prayers for critical natural resources. AI joins the quest. Recent advancements in technology have ushered in a new era of Nazca research. While satellites and drones had already improved the study of geoglyphs, artificial intelligence brought an unprecedented level of detail to the investigation. Between September 2022 and February 2023, a team led by Masato Sakai from Japan's Yamagata University partnered with IBM Research to employ AI in analyzing high-resolution photos of the desert plateau. Their goal was simple yet ambitious: to find previously unknown geoglyphs. The AI model, trained on existing images, scanned the region and flagged subtle patterns that human eyes might easily miss. The results were groundbreaking. Within 6 months, the AI-assisted survey identified 303 new relief-type geoglyphs, nearly doubling the total number cataloged since the early 20th century. These new figures included human heads, animals like camelids and killer whales, and even symbolic scenes depicting ceremonies. This fresh trove of discoveries revealed more than just numbers. Many of the new figures were small and located near ancient trails, suggesting a possible connection to travel and pilgrimage. Researchers believe these images may have served as teaching tools or spiritual prompts for those journeying across the desert. Understanding the symbolism and function.
Many of the Paracas images strongly resemble the newly identified hillside geoglyphs found in the Nazca region. It suggests the desert figures were created by the Paracas.
While new figures continue to surface, questions about the purpose of the Nazca lines still persist. But the accumulation of research now points increasingly towards symbolic and ritual use. Many of the newly discovered geoglyphs depict easily recognizable animals and human forms. In ancient Andean belief systems, animals were deeply connected to natural forces, life cycles, and agricultural prosperity. For example, depictions of camelids such as llamas and alpacas hint at the animal's importance in trade, transportation, and daily life. Killer whales, often seen in local mythology, symbolized strength and abundance. Human figures with exaggerated heads or eyes may represent sacrificial rituals or spiritual invocations. Sakai himself suggested that heads specifically might relate to offerings, citing their placement along paths associated with ceremonial travel. Processional routes remain a key part of interpreting the lines. Many larger line-type geoglyphs are situated along routes that could have hosted ritual parades or pilgrimages. Participants may have walked these paths while performing ceremonies intended to appeal to the gods for rain and agricultural success. Preservation, controversies, and future research.
Not all of the Nazca lines are made by Nazca people, and the Paracas were geoglyphing before it was cool. And because the images were on the walls of the valley, researchers thought they were meant to convey important cultural concepts to other people, so kind of like an early form of billboards.
Even as technology reveals new facets of the Nazca lines, preserving these fragile creations remains a serious concern. Though the desert's dryness protected the geoglyphs for centuries, modern threats have emerged. Mining, illegal settlement, and reckless tourism pose dangers to the preservation of the site. Episodes like the Greenpeace incident of 2014, which saw activists inadvertently damage part of the site, serve as stark reminders of its vulnerability. Other incidents have also raised alarms. Off-road vehicles and construction projects have scarred some sections, while floods and climate change threaten others. Authorities continue to monitor and manage these risks, but the challenge is considerable. Protective measures, including restricted access and fencing, aim to safeguard the lines for future generations. But research presses on. AI and drone technology have become invaluable tools for archaeologists. Not only do they help discover new geoglyphs, but they also assist in documenting and monitoring existing ones. Now it's time to hear from you. Do you think modern technology will eventually reveal all the secrets of the Nazca lines? Let us know in the comments section below.